what are you going to do today, then?
Tonight, a bit of shopping, probably.
You could always do a bit of cleaning.
It's my day off.
Hey, is this yours?
What?
This brochure for a campsite in Wales.
No.
It's probably just junk mail. But don't check it out, though, just in case.
If it's junk mail, why was it hidden under the cushion?
Kirky, you haven't.
Oh, morning.
Morning.
Sleep well?
Dad!
Only you could take a perfectly civil question and turn it into a faux pas.
No. Oh. Well, enough with the French. Not even awake yet. Toast okay?
Yeah, fine.
Oh, by the way, when I was getting my paper this morning, Norris asked me to pass a message on to you.
Norris?
Yeah, he owns a cabin, you know, little guy with glasses.
Yeah, nosy bloke. Lives next door.
Oh.
What did he want?
Well, he said that someone came looking for you yesterday, a woman called, what's her name? Joni. And according to Norris, she was very angry and hammering on our door. But take that with a pinch of salt, if I were you. You tend to exaggerate things.
So who's Joni, then?
She's the manager of the restaurant. Yeah, I took her keys by accident. She was pretty annoyed. But it's all sorted, though. I called her on the phone last night.
So how come she knew to come here?
Well, I told her where I was going to be in case there were any problems. I hope you don't mind.
No, not at all. I knew there'd be a perfectly simple explanation.
See, that's typical of folk round here. They're right gossip mongers. They'll be watching your every move.
I wanted to do something special, you know, with it being his 21st.
Yeah, so what have you got in?
Well, I booked onto a campsite in Wales. Earliest I could get was August 17th, though.
Oh, well, it'll be hotter by then in August.
Yeah. It's a surprise, though, so don't tell him. Mind you, Auntie Beth nearly blew it this morning, didn't she? She found the brochure. So I just had to rush Chaz out there quick.
Well, there's nothing like camping. Fresh air, closeness to nature.
Yeah, can't wait. Just a full week, just the two of us. Don't get me wrong, I love Auntie Beth and Kurt.
Oh, yeah, but sometimes it's nice to get away.
Exactly.
Thanks, Rob.
Thank you.
Do you know, it's a wonder you can taste that with all that brown sauce on it.
Could be worse, it could be ketchup, then you'd really have a go. Never really understood that.
Well, I always feel that sweet is slightly more common than savoury.
Yes, they'll pay for the windows now.
Oh, cheers. Thank you.
Well, why don't you take this out of it and keep the change?
Oh, thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Coffee takeaway, please, Roy.
You're looking very dapper these days, Kevin.
Yeah, well, I'm going to the bank, see if I can sort out a business loan.
Oh, well, good luck. Not that you'll need it. You look very impressive, doesn't it, Tim?
Right, I'm off to work, if you can call it that.
All right, then. I'll see you later. So, have you got a business plan as well?
Hiya.
Hi, love.
I was just coming to see if you were OK, you know, because of last night.
Oh, that's nice of you. Well, I'm coping, you know.
Good. Also, I was wondering if I could borrow a £5 for the bus. I'm going to see a mate.
Well, I suppose.
Actually, could you make that a tenner so then I can get some lunch?
As long as you promise to be back for your shift at the bistro.
I will. Thanks.
Right, I'll probably get a sandwich.
Oh,
OK. Bye.
Believe it. We're back together.
Me neither.
So, has there been anybody else, you know, seriously? Yeah, stupid question. It's bound to have been.
Well, there was someone.
And?
Just didn't work out. Couldn't get you out of my head.
Oh, well, I feel a bit guilty now, but, flattered, nonetheless.
I'd do a runner now, mate. She's poison.
Who the hell are you?
Her last victim.
Oh, well, that's a bit rich, isn't it? Coming from you. It's Tony.
Oh, him.
Told you she was the victim, did she? She's good at spinning things.
Hey, I was the victim. And Liz.
Don't you even mention her name. She's worth 10 of you.
Take a step back if I were you, while you've still got legs to.
Just Just remember that shop's still half mine.
Oh, yeah. Talking of the shop, a mate of yours came in the other day. He wanted paying for the foot spas. It's really weird, actually, because he looked exactly like the bloke that came in that day and roughed me up. You know, the one that you rescued me from. So I don't think the shop's going to be half yours for much longer because I like to work with people I can trust.
You think you're taking that from me too? You could forget it.
Time's up.
Is it? See ya.
You okay?
Yeah. Thanks.
If it ever bothers you again, ring me.
Oh, what a beaut.
What?
Have a look.
Oh, yeah, lovely, if you like old bangers.
Yeah, I could do her up. Make a fantastic trap car.
Well, if you're that keen, why don't you go and see it tonight?
No, it's a bit out of my budget.
Hey, up, here she is, the party girl.
Oh, no, you've not told him, have you?
Hey, us blokes tell each other everything. Feeling any better?
No.
Hey, these older women can't keep up with the pace.
Yeah.
Only kidding. It's me who couldn't keep up with her.
So what's this here about you chatting up Michael?
What? No, never. Luke.
I did have to carry her home, though, and that's the God's honest truth. Back will swear to it.
Oh, do you know, I came here for a bit of sympathy, not to be laughed at. I'm going now.
Hey, just don't go cutting any fringes, not till you can see out of both eyes Eddie Road.
Very funny.
You know what? I think I might go and have a look.
Well, yeah, you never know. He might drop the price.
Mm. Give him a call now.
You really?
I was bored.
Yeah, well, I'm busy at the minute.
I won't get anywhere. Promise.
Haven't you got any mates?
They're all kids. I really love your flat. It's so cool. I'm gonna have a place like this one day.
Right, well, find something to do. And don't natter. I need to concentrate.
No probs. You won't even know I'm here.
Just been looking at my old wedding album. You know, from when I married Robert. I can't believe that I wore bother boots.
I know. Wasn't it a second-hand dress?
Oh, yeah, from a charity shop. Yeah, I was really chuffed because it only cost me 14 quid. Oh, seems like a lifetime ago. Do you think I'm mad?
How could I? It's exactly what your mother and I did. Got divorced and then got back together again.
Oh, yeah.
And we worked out all right.
Yeah. You did.
Besides...
What?
I know it might sound a bit daft, but in a way, it was Deirdre who brought you back together again. Almost like she was giving you her blessing.
Have you finished your work yet?
No.
Should I make you a coffee or something?
Nope.
Have you thought any more about my trip?
You better go and buy a beret. You're about to go to Paris.
Really? You're gonna pay for it?
You owe me, okay?
Okay, thanks.
I'd go and see your mum now, but, you know, I've got a lot on today. Visits and that.
Right, so should I just go then?
You can always come along for the ride if you want. Go on. I'd enjoy the company.
Okay, then.
Great. Just gotta make a quick call. Mickey? Yeah, it's Callum. Need a favour, mate. Yeah, I'm calling it in now.
Look, I'll go if you want.
Eh?
You'd have to give me extra shifts.
Well, where's all this come from?
Oh, you seem a bit annoyed and you've hardly spoken to me all afternoon.
I'm not annoyed at you, I'm annoyed at life and the kind of cards it deals you.
Oh.
I mean, I know that I've been blessed in the looks department, but when it comes to, I don't know, get up and go, I'm sort of lacking, aren't I?
Right.
You know when people make New Year's resolutions? Well, I don't. It's not that I don't want to, it's just that I know that I'll never follow them through. What's the point?
True.
Yeah, but I should be more ambitious, shouldn't I? Because that's how you get somewhere. It's how you make something of yourself. It's how you attract a certain kind of woman.
I thought you were happy with Sally.
I am. That's the point. What have I got to offer apart from cleaning the windows for now?
Not a lot, I suppose. I can see the problem.
And it's not like you're even married.
Oh, thanks, mate. That's it.
What?
Carry on without me. I'll be back in a bit.
Bottom windows only, though.
Here. Here, where's Laurel?
Who?
You know Laurel, as in Laurel and... Oh, never mind. Hey, but if you don't come back soon, I shall be asking for a discount because I'm paying for the boss, not the apprentice. And don't get any graffiti on these walls, do you hear?
Gail,
wait. Are you doing?
Come to rub me nose in it? Gail, I am taking no pleasure in this.
In what? In stealing my husband?
Gail.
I didn't steal him.
You set out to nab him from the start. And you, fell for it. You walked straight into a trap.
Well, at least I can trust her.
I must say, she had that one coming. To work.
You, camping. That is hilarious.
I have been camping before, you know, when I was with the Brownies.
It was horrible. Yeah, so why did you book it then?
I didn't. Kirky did. See, when it was our 6-month wedding anniversary, I was saying it'd be dead nice to go away somewhere.
Do people even have a 6-month wedding anniversary?
That's what Kirky said. But anyway, he's made up for it now.
Hmm. Well, rather you than me.
Just jealous of my lovely bloke.
Excuse me, but I have my own lovely bloke, thanks to you.
Mm. Hey, stayed over last night.
About time. And he's coming back for more tonight.
Oh, I'm dead chuffy, yeah.
Coffee's to take out, please, Roy. Blind me. What was that for?
For being the best husband ever.
Oh, cheers.
I think it's dead romantic.
What is?
Don't be crass, but I know about the holiday.
What holiday?
It's no use pretending now. I've found the brochure. But it's still a lovely surprise.
Oh, as it is?
Yeah.
Nice one.
Where are you going?
Wales. Oh,
Sinead will be after me to do the same. I reckon I should book someone.
Perhaps not. I mean, there are other ways of being romantic. Chocolates, for example.
Not as good as a holiday, though, is it? What's the place called again?
I forget now. Anyway, got to go. Delivery to make. See ya.
Mm-hmm. Bacon butty, please, Roy. Hey, I was speaking to Joseph this morning. He looks great. I reckon the sun really suits him.
You saw him?
On my phone. I FaceTimed him, you know?
No, I don't. I do try to keep abreast, but sometimes I feel like I'm running on the spot.
What's the matter?
That was Robert. He said he can't meet tonight after all because the restaurant's too busy.
Well, the mountain won't come to Mohammed.
What? You mean...
Do you know where it is?
Well, no, but I know what it's called.
So let's get Googling.
Hey,
sorry.
It's all right. Yeah, I didn't know what you liked.
Oh, this is fine, thanks.
Yeah, if I didn't have to work, I'd take you out somewhere fancy for lunch. Maybe I should sometime.
This is fine. Beak's washing up.
Is that what you're meant to be doing now?
Yeah, at the bistro. It's not even minimum wage.
Shocking. Mm. No wonder you're bunking off. Anyway, you should be out having fun not acting as slave labour for your uncle.
Exactly.
This life, you got to look after yourself. No one else will. Remember that. Anyway, what's the fastest you've been in a car?
70, 75.
Well, we'll have to change that, won't we? Hold on to your seat, babe.
God, the rush is over.
Yeah. Look, Johnny, we need to talk. Why don't we call them back?
Sounds serious?
Yeah, it is.
I know what this is about. It's my paranoia. Look, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have gone round there.
You're not the sort of bloke to play away.
No, it's not that. It's just... Well, things haven't been good between us, have they?
My fault again? I don't know how you put up with me.
No, it's not your fault.
Look, we've got a lot going for us, you and me. I know we don't always see eye to eye, but what couple does? Robert?
Yeah, actually, maybe you're right. Let's talk later. Listen, love, why don't you go home and get your head down? You look bushed.
Are you sure you can manage?
Yeah, absolutely. Go on.
Am I forgiven?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, I'll see you in a couple of hours. Hey, surprise.
Do us a favour. I've got a nip and go see someone. You can send that to number 20. Just it'll save me some time. What? You can ask me favours, but I can't ask for one back. Don't worry, it's not drugs.
Thanks.
Cheers. And don't post it for the letterbox. Give it the bloke who answers. His name's Mickey, all right? Well, you're not scared, are you?
Of course not.
Good. I'll meet you back here.
And where we gone then?
Yeah, almost. So my friend's just texted me and she's got these vouchers for a new spa that's open in town. We're offering free massages and everything.
Well, sounds great.
Yeah, it is. It's just what I need. The only trouble is it's only on for tonight. Oh, Kurt, you couldn't have Liam for me tonight, could you?
Sorry, I'm a bit busy. Oh.
Never mind. Don't suppose you could... Have you already got someone on?
Nah, nothing that matters.
You sure?
Positive. What time do you need me?
In about half an hour.
See you then.
Brilliant. You're the best.
It's all right. Kirk's outside.
You all right, mate?
No, I'm in big trouble.
Why, what's up?
Beth thinks I'm the best husband ever, but I'm not.
Well, what have you done?
It's more what I've not done. Not booked her a holiday in Wales.
But Beth wants to go to Wales?
Worse than that, she thinks she is.
No, I'm sorry, mate, you've lost me.
She thinks I booked her a romantic break, but I haven't. And now I'm going to have to come clean.
No. There's a much safer option.
What?
Book one now, sharpish. Go on.
Mickey?
Yeah, why?
This is from Callum.
Not so fast.
He didn't say anything about that.
He'd be pretty mad if he doesn't get it.
Good girl. Today this could be
the greatest day of our lives. What's going on out there?
Must be some sort of event.
Oh, that's my favourite song. Loud, isn't it? Tim?
Go!
Sally Webster. You're gorgeous, funny, clever, and way too good for a bloke like me.
What's he saying?
I fell for you the minute I clapped eyes on you. Well, it wasn't the exact minute, and it was more that I fancied you than fell for you, but it wasn't long after.
Maybe it's about the birthday. Flipping toasty maker he got me, and that's only because he likes him.
Anyhow, I know I'm not much to look at and I don't deserve you, but I love you to bits, Sally Webster. Will you do me the honour of marrying me?
I can't hear you.
Will you marry me? Please.
Mmm. This chocolate stuff is to die for.
Yeah.
Try some.
Oh.
Yep.
That is almost as good as sex.
Yeah. It's a good job you're the one who made it, or you'd be out on your ear.
Listen, restaurant's going to start getting busy again soon. I really should head back to the kitchen.
Mmm. You go, don't mind us.
No, I think he means that we need to leave.
Well, it's not that I want you to go. I'm just.
It's all right. Hey. How much do we owe you?
Oh, don't worry, it's on the house.
Oh, really? Are you sure?
Of course he's sure. He's a proper gem.
Hang on a minute. Do I get a kiss or what?
Yeah.
Hey, come here. It felt awful leaving you to clear up, like... Let me guess. Tracy Barlow. Yeah? Who are you?
Tony. His wife!